Good morning. Today I will discuss determination of hash value. I am Dr. Kalpana Patil, Department of Pharmacognosy. So today we will learn how to determine hash value. So first, so what are the objective of the hash value? So by end of the topic, learners will be able to know concept of hash value, principle involved in hash value, how to determine total hash, acid insoluble hash, and water soluble hash. So the aim of the experiment is to determine the hash value of a crude drug. So here glassware and apparatus required, crucible, porcelain dish, muffle furnace. The principle involved in hash value is it is used to determine the quality and purity of a crude drug and to establish the identity of it. Hash contains inorganic radicals like phosphate, carbonate, silicates of sodium, potassium, magnesium, and calcium, etc. These are present in definite amount in a particular crude drug. Hence, quantitative determination in terms of various S value helps in their standardization. Sometimes inorganic variables like calcium oxalate, silica carbonate content of the crude drug affects total S value. Such variables are removed by treating with acid as they are soluble in hydrochloric acid and acid insoluble value is determined. For example, rhubarb, leucorice, etc. To determine foreign insoluble matter present as an impurity. Now, what do you mean by quality control? Quality control is a term that refers to processes involved in maintaining the quality or validity of a manufactured product. Regardless of the form of herbal preparation, some degree of quality control should exist. Without proper quality control, there is no assurance that the herb contained in the package is the same as that is stated on the outside label. Hash values are helpful in determining the quality and purity of crude drugs, especially in powder form. The objective is to remove all traces of organic matter which may otherwise interfere in an analytical determination. On incineration, crude drugs, normally blue and ash, usually consisting of carbonate, phosphate, and silicates of sodium, potassium, calcium, and magnesium. The ash remaining following ignition of herbal material is determined by three different methods. First is the total ash, acid insoluble ash, and water soluble ash. So total ash, that only used for the acid insoluble ash and water soluble ash. First, how to find out total ash? The total ash method is designed to measure the total amount of material remaining after ignition. This includes both physiological ash, which is derived from the plant tissue itself, and non-physiological ash, which is the residue of the extraneous matter like sand, soil, adhering to the plant surface. Acid insoluble ash. Acid insoluble ash is the residue obtained after boiling the total ash with dilute hydrochloric acid and igniting the remaining insoluble matter. This measures the amount of silica present, especially as sand and siliceous earth. Water soluble ash. Water soluble ash is the difference in weight between the total ash and the residue after treatment of the total ash with water. Now, how to proceed for the ash value? How to perform the total ash? Take 2 to 4 grams of the ground air-dried material accurately weigh in a TAD crucible. It is made up of platinum or silica. Spread the material in an even layer and ignite it by gradually increasing the heat to 500 to 600 degrees centigrade until it is white, indicating the absence of carbon. Cool in a desiccator and weigh. Calculate the content of total S in milligram per gram of air-dried material. Now, after that, the next is the acid in soluble ash. The total S were dissolved in 25 ml of hydrochloric acid and boiled for few minutes. The solution was filtered through S-less filter paper and washed with hot water until the filtrate becomes neutral. The filter paper containing the insoluble stuff was transferred to the original crucible and ignited to constant weight. The residue was cooled. Weight was recorded. The acid insoluble ash content was calculated in milligram per gram of air-dried material. Water soluble ash. So after doing the total S, the same S were dissolved in 25 ml of water and boiled for few minutes. The insoluble stuff was filtered by S-less filter paper, washed with hot water and ignited in a muffle furnace at a temperature not exceeding 450 degrees centigrade. Weight of this residue was subtracted from the weight of total ash and then water soluble ash in milligram per gram of air dried material. For this, the reference is Practical Pharmacognosy by Dr. K.R. Khandelwal and Dr. Vrunda Sethi. Thank you.